Abandon your world.
Welcome to Skybank. Thank you for coming. The retail business is a very important business for all banks because essentially what is retail banking is provision of banking services to individuals, you know, and small businesses. And in as much as you're a commercial bank, any commercial bank must be interested in retail business because that is really what you're set up for. You are set up to be there to meet the financial requirements and financial needs of the banking public, and that cuts across a wide spectrum from the lower middle class to the middle class to the high net worth individuals to those running small businesses. That is essentially your function, and for all the commercial banks in this country, it should be something that one should be keenly interested in. In terms of the profitability percentage wise, you know, I may not want to be so specific, but suffice it to say that it's a significant proportion of, you know, of our profitability, because again, retail business is the strength of retail is in numbers. So when you look at the different businesses in the bank, you may have some businesses on which you are able, you know, on which the profitability is on a few very, very large transactions. But of course, you need the numerical strength and the numbers of many people in many locations across the country, all adding up to give you the profitability that you want. Because if you look at yourself as an individual, everybody runs a bank account. A lot has been said about financial inclusion. So even now we're moving that it's not only educated and literate people should have bank accounts, even those in the rural areas should have bank accounts. Everybody has a bank account, and all the different amounts of money, it all adds up. You know, people run transactions, they pay fees. You know, by the time you do that in a million places, you get the sort of profitability you desire. So you are making your profits over a large number of customers in a large number of locations, which is important, as opposed to a merchant bank, for instance, where you make your profitability, where your profitability comes from large transactions over a small number of customers. That's why for retail banking and retail business, it's essential that you have a very good branch network. At Skybank today, I think we operate from 247 locations across the country. There's no state in which there's not a Skybank presence. In some states, there's a stronger presence than the others, but there's no state that we're not represented. In Lagos, I'm sure there's no local government in which we're not represented. And that's our aim. Because another thing with the retail business is that you have to be readily accessible to the people that you want to serve. The issue on the public sector, the cash reserve or public sector funds, is an important issue for all the banks, as you are a gentleman of the press and it's been reported widely, because essentially it reduces the amount that you have for lending, and that's important for every bank. Skybank, we operate well and with strength in many areas. We operate in the investment banking area. We operate in the retail banking space, as I've said earlier. We also operate in the public sector area very well. We have very good relationships and strong relationships at federal and state levels in most states. So of course this has an impact on us. But the drive for retail, it becomes even more important for us as with many other banks now. But this drive for retail is something that we've been pursuing at Skybank for actively for the last 5 years. It was about in 2008 where the retail banking business was extracted, as it were, from the main business, where retail banking was taken out as something that should be given a specific focus since 2008. So you know that it's something we've been trying to drive separately. We didn't want it to be mixed with the commercial banking and merchant banking and state, so we took it out and had retail banking officers, a retail banking group head and all that, so we could give that focus on it. That's been on for 5 years, but it turns out now, and in anticipation of things like this, that you always have to build a very strong retail base, because really that is your strength in the numbers and all that. So it's something that has always been there for us, but of course now it becomes even more important that we drive down very clearly in that area and make sure we deliver value to this category of customers, so that we can get a large proportion of the availability of retail business in the environment. Definitely, once you move, I mean, you're moving out of the public sector, because everybody knows that in Nigeria the government is the biggest spender. So you can never move out of the government. There's no bank that's going to move out of banking the government, in as much as we are allowed to bank the government. But of course, you now have to start to look more critically at your retail banking business, where you have a large number of customers. It is the aggregate of the money that you mobilize from a large number of retail customers that gives you the volume that you need. So instead of getting 500 million naira from one location, you may need to get 1,000 people before you mobilize that volume of deposits. So the retail business becomes very important on an individual level. Then again, you now look at the small businesses, small and medium businesses, which is also another very important. I mean, when we look at it, when we look at the number of the Nigerians that are in the paid employment sector, it's not a huge proportion. A large number of people are self-employed, and even increasingly now, we are all encouraging young people to be entrepreneurial and to be self-employed instead of waiting endlessly for jobs that may not materialize. So the small and medium business is an area we have a group again dedicated to building small and medium-sized businesses, because we recognize this. And SMEs are the engine of growth in developing economies, and we have recognized this. So yes, you say there are risks in these environments, and there are risks. The risks in the SMEs is because they're principally owned, the decisions are made by one person. They're closely held businesses. In a lot of instances, it's either one man and his wife, one man and his children, you know, and there's nothing wrong with that. There's nothing wrong with the closely held businesses. In countries all over the world, you have a huge conglomerate that started as one man, his wife and his children. So there's nothing wrong with that. What it is important is that the structures must be built, and people must have the financial discipline to separate themselves from their businesses. That's where the risk often comes in, because we find that in Nigeria, people do not often separate themselves from their businesses. So the money that comes in for the business is for general spending. So before you say Jack Robinson, the money that has come in to execute a job has gone towards feeding the family, paying school fees and meeting all sorts of consumer needs. And that's really where the risk is. Again, where people don't have clear structures, there's an opportunity for a lot of loss, a lot of pilferage. For people that are not strong in accounting and won't want to employ an accountant, they can lose money because of poor accounting. They may not realize when they're making losses and profits. All those things make those businesses a high risk for the bank. But of course, if you're able to get it right, it's a high risk and it's a good return. And it's a good return apart from the personal satisfaction that one derives from building a business that belongs to Nigerians and taking it from one level to another. There are people that I've started with in my career where we started off loaning them, you know, 5 million naira to start something, and even over the years, we have watched them over 10 years, they're now borrowing 500 million naira. There are people that have started one restaurant franchise and now have a chain. There are people that have started one boutique and now have four locations. And that, apart from it shows you that SMEs can be profitable if they're managed, you know, there's good financial discipline. And that's just a great reward for me as a banker when you see businesses being run by Nigerians going from strength to strength. So there are risks in the SME area, no doubt about that, but there's also reward. And again, that is really what we are here to do. Our primary responsibility is financial intermediation, mobilizing deposits from those who have them and loaning the available funds to those who need them. That is the primary responsibility of a bank. So we try and do the best that we can. So another thing that has risen over the past few years for individuals is the availability of consumer finance, personal credit. You find out now that most people that are in paid employment, you can buy a car. Once you run a salary, then you can buy a car, you can get a mortgage, you can do household appliances, you can do things that makes life easier and have flexible payment plans in as much as you have a salary. So for instance, in that regard, we have made those things possible, but we still largely restricted them to people that are salaried, because that's a way of control. You work for the Guardian, or you work for this day, and you will work there for a year, and you are a confirmed staff. We can make money available for you to buy a car, or we can make money available for you to, you know, to do, you know, buy a generator, to buy personal appliances, and stretch your payments over time. But the control element in that is that you're salaried, and your salary account resizes up. So that is how we'll control it. For instance, we won't give loans to just any individual who comes, you know. You have to be sure that you have a regular income, and that income is such that you have some sort of control over it. So that's one form of control. For small and medium enterprises that want leases with us, you know, once you run your account, we'll say, okay, run your account with Sky for 3 to 6 months. Let's see how this business is running. And then we'll give you a lease to buy a generator. You know, I will spread it over a reasonable period of time. We'll help you to buy equipment for your business, and we'll spread it over a reasonable period of time. But what we ask, your account will be opened with us, and you'll run your account with us for a while. That gives us a control. Now, where it is possible, in as as often as possible, we prefer to acquire assets. That's because of what I said to you about the financial discipline, you know, so that people don't just take overdrafts and just go up, you know, because sometimes if it's a closely held business, you have an overdraft with the bank, you need money as an individual. It's so easy to take money out of the overdraft to meet your individual needs, but it requires a lot of discipline to put it back, and it requires a lot of discipline not to access your company funds when you are the sole signatory, you know. So we try and make it that, okay, if you have LPOs to execute, we give you LPO financing, and we sort of restrict it. If you want to acquire an asset, we'll say, okay, these are the vendors you can buy from, we'll pay the vendor directly, you know, or we'll ask you secure it and make you secure it as something that's of value to you, so that you also have something to lose. So these are all the things. Of course, there will always be some people that slip through the net, there'll be some people that are ingenious, but once you put the basic controls in place for SMEs, you'll find that people want to build their businesses, and if they have a bank that's able to support them, they don't want to break that trust. So that is there. So that's number one. So I think I've spoken about the risks for individuals and how we try and cover that, and then the risks for the SMEs. Another thing that has helped and is reducing risk in SME lending is the credit bureau. Now, any loan above is a million naira is registered, so you can check and be sure that you are not owing or you don't have delinquent accounts in other banks. So that's a very big problem for a Nigerian, because what happens, people typically in Nigeria, we don't really keep very good records, at least in the past. So people come to Skybank, they borrow, they have a bad loan, they drop it, they move to Sterling, they borrow, they have a bad loan, and that's just a bad habit that a lot of people have as Nigerians. But now, if you come to Skybank and you have a bad loan, when you're going to Sterling, they will make a credit reference, do a credit check on you, and if that credit check says that you have a delinquent loan somewhere, they will not give you that credit in Sterling until you go and resolve the issue in Sky. If they do so, if they decide to overrule it at another bank, they do so at their own peril. And a lot of banks, their risk management procedures will not even allow them to do that. Because don't forget that over the last 4 years, the supervision from the banking supervision is a lot stricter. The regulations, the regulators are a lot stricter on the banks. So even there are some things that even if you'd have wanted to exercise discretion in the past, you are no longer able to do so. And for as much as your bank is, you may have a large, a significant base of public sector deposits, but you will also have access to other deposits, other large deposits, institutional deposits that are significant in volume. So what it simply means is that you have to go out more aggressively. So it's a tough and a busy time for everybody, because everybody is out doing the same thing, looking for the institutional investors that have significant funds and aggressively building their retail banking business. Like you said, retail banking, it's a game of numbers. So where you were focusing only on Lagos, now you spread your tentacles and you focus everywhere. You're everywhere getting all your people to mobilize and to go out and get the money in different places. You're going to wherever the money is to go and make sure that you bring the money in. So it makes you that much more aggressive. It makes everybody sit up and it makes everybody put in their best, because there's nothing to do and there's no magic to perform except to bring in more deposits. And you just have to. So, and when 24 of you are looking for the same thing, it's tough, but you know, you just get on with it, because that's really what they're going to do, and they're not going to change it. They're going to change it in the interim. This is what it is for now, so we work with what it is for now and we do the best we can, and we make sure that we make sure that we go out and even get even more deposits. We make sure that you go out and get retail customers, and then you make sure that you work aggressively on the inside to improve your service, because it's one thing to bring the deposits in, it's another thing to retain the deposits in the system, and what retains the deposits in the system is service. So that's another, you know, area that's very, very important to us, because retail banking really and customer service, they're just two sides of the same coin. One drives the other. I think it was our advert that said, that gave the impression we were a happy bank. I think that was the Hakuna Matata advert. And no worries when you're with Skybank. And I think that must have been what created that impression. So, we're enterprising, pleasant, happy, but certainly serious. It's like we're trying to, you're always, if you say, have a philosophy of expanding your world, you're always trying to make things better for people. You said that what is the threshold for retail customers? Now, for all individual accounts are retail accounts. So whether that individual account is a civil servant, at the lower levels, that we just call them, those are mass retail customers. Then you have the upper middle income and the more affluent customers. We call those are priority banking customers. But all in the, and of course you have the extremely high net worth customers. All individual accounts, individual current accounts, individual savings accounts, they are all classified retail. That's number one. Then we have our SBG group, called that small and medium business group. And we try and look at that roughly, it varies, but we'd say roughly businesses that are doing turnovers up to about 350 million naira in a year in turnover. We classify that as a small and medium enterprise. And why we try and extract that again is that whenever you extract the business types from the major group, it means that they don't get lost. It means you can tailor, you know, because a business that's even running up to 500 million a year, 350, 400, they have, you know, their needs, they have things they need bridging facilities. So it just helps you to extract those category of businesses, look at what they need more closely and present them with tailor-made solutions. So this expanding your world, in narrowing what it is that we want to, the groups that we're dealing with, you're able to look at them more closely and then realize, okay, what is it that they really need? And what is it that they really, what do they want and what do they need? And strike a balance between what they want and what they need. And really look at it very closely and give them things that are, you know, specific to their group. And then again, sometimes you look at it, you drill down to their sector and you give them things that are specific to their sector. So that's the way that it really works. And all the while, the underlining thing is really service. And we try and make sure we keep a strong focus on that. Another thing I did mention about Skybank retail banking is that we look at it and our objective is we want to be relevant to customers, individuals, whichever phase of life they're in. So there are products for children, there are products for youth, there are products as those are you're just starting out in life, you know, starting out your work and all that. Then those consumer products that you can, once you get a job, you can use to acquire things. And the investment products, where you're in retirement and you need investments and you need to be careful about your finances, reduce your financial charges. So we just try and make sure we're relevant all across the lifespan. Now for women and children, we don't have any gender-based products. And my reason for this is quite simple, that if you're running a business, it doesn't matter whether you're a man or a woman, the challenges are the same. So I really, personally, I'm not a strong believer in gender-based products because the things that you encounter as a business person in Nigeria, they're not gender-specific. Alright, you're going to have a staff that you have to watch carefully. If you don't watch them carefully, they're going to steal your money. You're going to find what are the challenges you have in packaging your product so that the target market will buy. How do you package your business so that you can access financing from the bank? Those are the things that are really important. It's not about gender, and we try and focus on that. In point of fact, we're having our first financial advisory seminar in September, on the 5th of September, and we're going to be talking to our SBG customers, and we're going to be saying to them, okay, giving advice, we get speakers, people that have run that path before, and then we'll talk to them about how to run bank accounts, because I'm always surprised how little people know about running bank accounts, even though when they run people, even just to bank your money and the benefits of banking and the things you can do. So we'll run those sort of things. People will come to us and we'll give them advice. In as much as possible, we'll try and give people facilities to expand their businesses. So I think that's a lot more important than saying, oh, we want to give this for women and that for women. I know there are grants that one can access through multilateral agents for women specifically, but in terms of, so that's a different thing. If there's a company, there's a multilateral agency that wants to promote women and give them grants, that's another thing. But for running your bank account, especially, really, I don't think gender is a significant issue. But for children, we have our Rainbow Savings account, which is a children's account, and we try and make it an account that's interesting for the children. So up until now, the rewards have been largely things that are of interest to children. We've had gifts, you know, gift items for account opening, promotions where children do things. We have accounts. Recently, we had for May 27th, we had a shopping spree that people that had were able to put a certain amount of money in their account and hold it for a period, qualified for a shopping spree. The kids had like 20,000 naira. They went to different shops, ShopRite, and they bought whatever they wanted. You know, they only said that it has to be things, you know, for children, and they had shopping vouchers. And that was great fun for everybody. But now we've realized that in these times are a bit financially tight, that we have to give benefits that will also be attractive to parents. And so for that, we've recently added an insurance element to our Rainbow product, which means that should there be an instance of disability or death of the parent, the child will become eligible for an account balance, a maximum of ₦1 million for each child, irrespective of the balance of the account. It will be a proportion of the balance, but the maximum will be ₦1 million. So we're hoping that that would attract people, because people are always interested, and things happen to friends, things happen to family, and it gets people thinking, what would happen to my children if anything should happen to me? So it does not say that people, of course, will continue to do their life insurance and get other things in place, but at least now there's an insurance element. So it's fun for the child. You get gifts, you get to come to things, you get to, you know, random gifts and random surprises, but there's also now a benefit for the parents as well, in terms of financial security. That's number one. We also have an account for youths. We have a teen card, the Rainbow Teens, because we say that our Rainbow account really ends at about 12. Then we have a teen card. You know, sometimes the 15-year-olds, they just don't like to be spoken of in the same breath as the 6-year-olds. So we have a card, which is an ATM card. So their own account is card-based. It means that you can put money on their account, and when they're going out to KFC or wherever it is they're going, they can make their payments by themselves. There's a restriction to the amount of money that can be on their account, so there's no wastage. But the children also learn discipline, and they learn how to plan for, you know, their money. So that's the teen card. And then lastly, for that category, we have a youth account. We call our youth account the Campus Plus card. And we sell this to undergraduates in tertiary institutions, universities, and all manners of tertiary institutions. Again, it's card-based, but it's a card that is web-enabled, so you can do online transactions on it. We've recently gone, we've recently gone an awareness campaign on this. We had done about 13 campuses across the country until the ASU strikes. And of course, as soon as the universities are reopened, will go straight back, you know. So what it is that it's a card that they can use, is web enabled. You know, they do so much online, they register online, they check the results online, they do so many things online, and they buy a lot online, that category of customers. So we had to be something. And then we are launching later this month a youth engagement platform, which will be something that's very interesting. So there'll be things of interest to them: jobs, careers, music, football, you know, things that will be of interest to youth. So we're hoping by this to engage them more. You know, because you know that for the youths now, they're just so into engagement. They're always talking on Twitter, they're always commenting, always posting, always blogging. So you have to have something where they can go and make comments of things that are of interest to them. And we believe that our youth engagement platform will do just that. So that's really what we have specifically for children across the spectrum. And of course, once you go out of university and that campus, and you just migrate into a regular savings or a regular individual current account as a worker, and we take the journey, your life cycle, on from there. Now, Sky Dreams is something that we have in Sky Bank, which is actually unique. It is, we're the only bank now that's running a live and effective loyalty program. Sky Dreams is a loyalty program. It's not a promo, it's just an ongoing program. And what we've said is, just like the way you have loyalty programs on airlines or whatever, is that you use your account and you earn points. So we said that, okay, if you have a savings account with Skybank and you maintain 30,000 naira in your savings account for 30 days, you qualify for Sky Dreams. If it's individual current, it's 50,000 naira. And then for our Sky Select account, which is a higher value individual current account, it's 100,000 naira. And it is, what it is that for maintaining those balances, you qualify. For qualifying, you earn points. And then subsequently, you earn additional points for the lodgement into your account in multiples of 10,000 naira. Now, points, we allow the accumulation of points for a 12-month period. After a 12-month period, at the end of the year, any unutilized points will go. But different, of course, as your lodgements get greater, your points get more. And you'll be surprised that you can use these points that you accumulate to buy things from recharge cards. For people that are just doing, it can be things from recharge cards, it can be telephones. We have a lot of people buying generators, air conditioners, household appliances. We have a relationship with Emirates, South African Airways, and Virgin. You can buy as much as business class tickets if your balances are that heavy and you have enough points. So what it is, Sky Dreams, is that you're keeping your balances on your account, you are banking with the bank, you are leaving your deposits there, you are earning points that can enable you to do other things that you won't need to spend cash. And it's not something that you require so much money to start. So even if all you want to do is buy a handset for yourself or a handset for your child, you can accumulate your points until you get to the point that you need to buy the handset of 12,000 naira. And again, you can accumulate your points and use to buy a BlackBerry, you can buy a laptop, you can buy whatever you do. So we have specific vendors that we deal with to also make sure that there's a certain level of uniformity in the products that we have. But that's a very, we are going on an awareness campaign on Sky Dreams now, because I think that's something that's very important that we have, but for which there is not enough awareness. Again, because loyalty programs are new to Nigeria, but we're going to do a lot of awareness on this so that we can and let more people know. And of course, do this, you know, like I said, when all the banks have the same objective, which is to mobilize retail deposits, you have to have a very unique way of mobilizing your own retail deposits. And for us, our loyalty program is one. We recently launched a service charter just last week. And for us, that just shows our commitment to service. Because when you have in print, it's one thing to say we have service standards and all that, but when you now put it in print, you give people the opportunity of opening a page in a book and saying, you promised me so and so and you're not delivering. I know nobody wants to be in a situation where they will not be able to deliver what they put in print. So you know that we're going to be working assiduously to meet all those things that you have said. You see, the thing about customer service is not really rocket science. It's just what people want. It's what people expect. People want, you know, and when you talk about individuals, I need to just think about yourselves. You want a bank that is readily accessible. It's either near to the place you live or the place you work. You want a bank that provides services and that the people are responsive. When you make a call, they pick up the phone. When you write a letter, they respond. When you send an email, they respond. You want a bank that is safe, that's financially safe, that your money is safe, that you're sure of. You want a place where you can invest safely, you can put your money on deposits or in savings, and you want a place where you can borrow when the need is. So I think the thing is, for us, the first step was to have defined our services very carefully and then decided what level we want to attain on each of the services, and then put ourselves on the spot, really, by putting it in writing in a charter that this is what we're going to do. So I dare say everybody in Skybank is now bound by that service charter, and we must all try our best to live up to the expectations of what we ourselves have written, because the service charter was a collective effort. Everybody that is working here, is even at executive levels, nobody can claim ignorance of what is there. So it's just something that we've got to work hard on. So customer service is largely, you know, it's the delivery of the service. And the delivery of the service is so bound up in attitudes and all that of individuals. So we spend a lot of time and resources committed to training our individuals so that they relate to people in a way that's pleasant and amiable, where they have a problem-solving mentality, because that's important. Another thing, customer service is problem-solving. You have to have an orientation to solve problems, not just to want to say, oh, come back tomorrow and let me talk to my colleague. So we try and train our people in that way, to have vibrant and responsive people, especially at the front of this point. And it's a continuing exercise. You're continually recruiting, you're continually training, you're continually fine-tuning even those people that are there. So that's really what it is. Just also like to talk a bit about our products. I think we've spoken about our Sky Dreams, that's our loyalty program. Then we have a host of savings and current products. Flagship individual current account, that's our Sky Select account, which is for middle income customers or upper middle income customers. Maintain a balance of 100,000 naira, and the account is COT free. And what it is that we have priority pass cards, which is especially important at this time of year when a lot of people take their vacation. And what it means is that a Sky Bank account holder, you have a priority pass card which enables you to use lounges in maybe 500 cities across the world, regardless of your class of travel. So you are traveling economy, you can go and sit in a lounge and pay a token fee, because we paid for the membership fee. So what you just pay is a token and have the benefits of using a lounge. That's important for people. For higher value customers, we say that you have access to a priority traveler package. So that also gives you discounts on hotels, discounts on car hire, and access to a baggage retrieval service should you lose your baggage. We have our SkyWise account, which is a hybrid account, a hybrid savings account. I mean, you can pay checks into that account if you have references, and you can also draw cash. You can have third-party payments, as you can send somebody to draw cash from any of our banks across the network. That's our SkyWise. We have a SkyWise Classic account, which is for corporates. so that you can pay checks, you can pay cash. But it's once your cooperative is registered, you're able to open a Skywise Classic account, and that's quite important. I think the minimum balance on that is 20,000 naira. So that's something that a wide range of cooperatives can go with. Recently, a lot has been said, and all of you as financial journalists know that a lot has been said about financial inclusion. And for this product reason, we have also introduced products Skyflex and SkyEase, one with a maximum limit of 200,000, another with a maximum limit of 400,000. So really, the difference with these accounts is just that the documentation is minimal. Essentially, you really just need a passport photograph. Passport photograph, you can use third-party identification, just that we restrict it to cash withdrawals. We don't allow web transactions. And then again, of course, we have a strong money transfer, a remittance department that deals with the remittance business and money transfer. We have Western Union Transfer Services, and we're quite big on Western Union. We're amongst the top four banks in Western Union service bank-wide. And then we have the MoneyGram. We have MoneyGram. We offer the MoneyGram services. And we started about 18 months ago, and it's gaining ground very well. We also have our own African payment service, where people can make payments to and from our banks in our African subsidiaries. That's in the Gambia, in Sierra Leone and Guinea, which means that from a Skybank branch, you can send money for collection in Guinea and Sierra Leone or Gambia, and vice versa, and it's not restricted to account holders. So these are the other things that we're doing, the money transfer business, and of course a large number of money transfer organizations, smaller ones, that make payments through Skybank outlets. So we just try and make sure that we're relevant to individuals at every level, whether it's the money you're receiving from your spouse or your parents, whether it's financing, whether it's school, whether it's college, whether it's investment in company. And that is really the retail business. And for retail now, you need a strong technology platform, so services can be delivered quickly and with minimal cost. And then you just need your of course, efficient, strong and efficient technology platforms, the back-end service, and you just constantly need to be thinking about what individuals want. And really, in retail business, is not so difficult, because you think, what do I want as a banker? And what do my children want? And what do my older relations want? And what do my retired aunties and uncles want? And you just look, what do people really want? And you find that people are not really looking for complicated things. They're just looking for accessible, inexpensive, and these days, quick. And now, I think with the internet and technology, the emphasis is on quick. Everybody wants everything faster and cheaper. So that's really our challenge, is to maintain quality while delivering swift service at a minimal price. And that's really what. Yes. Yeah, we do a lot in health, we do a lot in education. Only last week, I'm very proud to say that we donated a mammogram to an NGO that's called Scope. Yes, and yes, breast cancer screening machine to Cope. And I personally am just so proud to have done that, to have been involved in that initiative as a bank, because it's so important. And as common as it is, it's just not readily available. I was talking to somebody and I was quite surprised to find out that it's just not so easy to just go and have these things done at an affordable price. So we've done that. We did an accident and emergency ward in Louth at a point, and that's just two things. We've done a lot in the area of health, emergency services and critical services in health. Education is important. We also recently, last month, we were involved in a project with the Obafemi Awolowo University, Bafanayo University, and an international organization, where we donated an ICT center. And that ICT center, Obafemi Awolowo University is quite advanced technology, and their whole campus is wired up, but it's one of its kind. They can deliver lectures, virtual lectures. It's got a 400-seater facility with personal computers, everything fully equipped. They've got a software development area there. We've done a lot of work there, and I'm also very proud of that, we are all very proud of that, because it's something that technology is a way of the future. There are a lot of bright minds, and it's important that we help to develop that. We need to start having centers of excellence, for different things. And I believe Obafemi Awolowo University is a center of excellence for software development or ICT. I think it's actually been selected as a center of excellence. So it was great to partner with them on that. So we've done that. I mean, of course, we've done countless things for at smaller levels, for primary schools, for public schools, you know, and all that. Those things are ongoing. But I would say generally health and education. And the emphasis for me, on health for me is so important because it just can't be enough. There's just so much that can be done at local government, at state and federal levels in health. And it's just something that I think that the private sector must take on, because the public sector can't do it alone. Thank you very much.